Crenshaw Memorial Stadium. Home of the CE King Panthers, who gave us none other than Louis Belina, a product of King High School. And we are live here for College Station Cougar football. Chase Murphy, Scott Clendenin, and it is just about time to get started. Hey, we said 7 o'clock start. How about a 7:39-ish start for the Cougars and the Panthers? And let's talk starting lineups, at least for the College Station High School Cougars. And we begin with the right side of the offensive line, Josh Donovan.
And I think a good brotherhood a lot of times leads to a better ball game for us, because we get thoughts in our head, and it's thoughts that we as brothers can feed energy off of before a game. It's always right there. We're thinking about it. And so a good brotherhood, a lot of times, I mean, we've pulled wins out because of things we've heard from speakers of brotherhood.
Definitely. I think, I mean, especially like Coach Huff's speeches, it helps us realize that tomorrow is game day, and we need to start funneling into that focus point of when we step on that field, it's time to go. And I think that's what, I mean, I think it's what it really hits you is when you walk in, it's like tomorrow's game day. Like, it's about to go down.
It's basically the beginning of pregame. That's
exactly
how I see it.
Tomorrow's game day.
Oh, you will see me thrive. Can write my story. I'm beyond the archetype. I won't just conform. No matter how you shake my core, 'cause my roots, they run deep. Oh, oh yeah, so little faith. Don't doubt it, don't doubt it. Victory is in my veins. I know it, I know it. And I will not negotiate.
Just fight it, I need your soul. from the siren. Yeah. Ooh. Oh yeah. Ooh. Extra, extra, read all about it. We getting turned up if you know you're about it. Say. Ooh. Oh yeah.
Feel the ring, the octagon to the court, baby. The new kids on the block, over here fight, dominating the debate. Now they take a second take. Oh, hold up, wait, it's time to skip all the other stuff. It's shining sharp, Peter Sharpest, that's why he cutting up. You don't know Skip Bayless, rock, you been under one. Eyes don't lie, just hope you see where I'm coming from. Numbers don't lie, this the Fox Sports 1-1. No mercy, no mercy, no mercy, and I won't back down. No mercy, no mercy. No mercy, and I won't back down. No, let's go face to face. I embrace debate. I don't make mistakes, I just make my case. Drop spike when I'm done. What more can I say? Back bite to my tongue. I don't like the taste. I'm on and I'm on and I own my opponent. I'm always in the zone, either zoned out or zoning. And we could get it poppin'. Pick the topic if you want. Skip and shine, skip the hopping. Took these sports and made them pop it. Alright, you are kidding me. Whoa. No mercy, no mercy, no mercy, and I won't back down. No mercy, no mercy, no mercy, and I won't back down. No, fearless, relentless, fearless, relentless, fearless, relentless, fearless, relentless. No mercy, no mercy. No mercy, and I won't back down.
No mercy, no mercy,
no mercy. No mercy, no mercy, no mercy, and I won't back down.
No mercy, no mercy,
no mercy, and I won't back down. No.
Took my first breath where the muddy rises, spills into the Gulf of Mexico, where the skyline's colored by chemical plants that put bread on the table of the working man, where the working man does his best to provide safety and shelter for kids and a wife. giving a little of a soul every day, making overtime to keep the wolves away. Barely 13 when the company man tried to dig my daddy's grave. It happened on a French-owned tanker ship, spilling poison in the Galveston Bay. Well, the liquid fire filled his lungs and his eyes, silenced any more cries. Cold in the grave, with death stinging pain, he fought like hell. Keep the wolves away. As a dog, but he made a recovery just to spite the odds. The settlement came and we moved out of town, where the sky isn't heavy with refinery flats. Yeah, he's still alive, he's doing good, he's in his 50s, but the money's running out and he's painting for pennies. So I'm going for broke with every song I play, 'cause now it's my turn to keep the wolves away.
Brotherhood. For me, brotherhood meant like all of us getting closer, you know. This is a time where we all bond and get together. It brings us closer, and made our chemistry more tight and everything. Like, we were all together, made us like work harder more and everything. Like, we pick each other up and work for each other.
Being able to come together once a week and just talk with my brothers and, I don't know, see how their week went and just connect as a team, I felt like really helped us throughout the season. We had a better bond, we communicated better, we could feed off each other in a sense, just making a bond that lasted a long time.
After going through the season, I realized some of like who my very best friends were. You know, I had people who I considered my best friends outside of football, but I realized that the bonds that I made with my brothers really outweighed that going through, whether it be in the locker room, on the field, just everything. I really brought in how I felt about my brothers and coaches.
I don't know if this is about y'all, but like, I think one cool part about brotherhood was like, you know, end of the week, you know, we're not trying to kill each other anymore. We're going to just like sit down and you're like, you know, how's the family? You know, how's school going? You know, how's the girl situation going? And, you know, just kind of get to know each other, you know, on that level.
Yeah, I mean, I agree. I just love being able to, like, you know, even though we were all kind of in our different groups at lunch, or at our tables when we ate, like, you know, line and everything, like, we were still, like, together, and, like, you know, the fact that we all got to go up, you know, almost all of us, at least all the seniors, got to go up and speak to our brothers, like, I feel like that was a really big deal, because I know, like, you don't feel like it should be a big deal, but, like, I remember every time I'd be like, oh, if this is me, like, I'm thinking about what I'm going to say, because, you know, it's a big thing to be able to, like, go out there and talk to your brothers and tell them how you feel.
I mean, it was obviously a great experience and something you look forward to and work towards. I mean, when I started off playing like Raiders and Tigers, it was always looked up to the high school guys. And being able to finally be there and kind of do it for yourself and experience it yourself is a big deal, and kind of what I set out to do is make the most of it.
Yeah, just everything we went through in this season, the challenges we faced in games, how we persevered and succeeded through that together as a team. I think that really grew our bond as like brothers and such, and it really helped us get as far as we did.
I feel like last year our brotherhood was pretty good, but this year, I don't know, it's like even in the locker room, we don't even have to be in like a brotherhood meeting on Thursdays. Even in the locker room, we were vibing together. We were like protecting each other like we were our own blood brothers. Like, I think that's why we went so far this year.
I think it's a little different, you know. You're safe. You know, this is like your group of brothers. You know, I mean, you can say whatever's on your mind, and no one's gonna judge you for it.
Exactly. You know what I mean? The fact that like just we made it so far and went through so much, I felt like it just like it made everything just bigger and better. Like, the farther we went, the closer everyone got, the more it meant, and it just brought us together more as a team and more as a family, more so than just like, oh, we're just guys playing together. Like, it was different than that. It was always like, we're all brothers to each other.
So my first year playing for competition football, this brotherhood and stuff, it really touched my heart. I remember me being part of a program that everybody cared for each other, everybody getting along. We all tell each other everything, we have fun, we don't each other, but to push us to be better players and to help each other out. And Coach Barry, been with me since my freshman year. I love him to death. How we didn't get along.
I feel like it made us closer as a team, beyond the field. So I think that helped us on the field as well.
Yeah, it kind of made us like more connected to each other. Like, it's more on a personal level rather than just being teammates. We're like actual family, so it kind of helped with our team chemistry on the field. And we knew each other.
Like, brotherhood overall was just like a good experience. It's like taught a lot of us, you know, not to judge each other, even though we're from different backgrounds, things like that. Like, football, just brotherhood in general taught me how to like not to give up on things, you know, always have each other back. You know, in life, things gonna be different. Things gonna be hard, but especially when you persevere.
It's a different experience than just like going out with your buddies for dinner. You get to
socialize, but also get to like get that selfish connection that you get to bring to games. And like Cliff said, like after you go through this so long of a run, then like you're getting stronger and stronger and stronger, and it just helps so much in the game.
I know to me, times I'll never forget, we're in the locker room and we would just mess around. And it was a good time. It was special.
One of the coolest things that I thought football being a center on the offensive line is your relationship with your quarterback. And the fact that I got to start my senior season, never thought I'd start a game of football on varsity especially, but I got to start for Ty. I mean, Ty, he's going to go somewhere and play. He's going to do great things, but just sitting there before our first game, going through a weather delay, I'm just thinking how nervous I am and everything, and I'm just thinking the whole time, like, I got to do this for my team, for Ty. I mean, he's just sitting there calm, and I'm probably thinking, like, in my head, just, dude, I'm going to mess everything up, and just how much it meant to me. So I went over and talked to him. We just had, like, a chat for about 15 minutes while we had the weather delay about, like, it's both of our first games in a long time, like varsity and all that, and we're both starting, and just the impact and what it meant to us playing together.
Cool story about Coach is, we didn't do it as much this year, but Coach Huff, he would always bet me Gatorade if I could kick the ball into a little net that the quarterbacks use. And so he'd put it, I don't know, the 20-yard line, and set me up on one of the hash marks and have me kick some pooches, which are just, I pop the ball up as high as I can and try to make it in the net. And I would hit the actual net. I wouldn't make it in. I would hit the bar, the crossbar kind of, and he would give me a Gatorade cap and say, didn't make it in, but here's a Gatorade cap. Good try. It's basically a good try.
I want to talk about y'all as my brothers and being my brothers, like connecting through football and athletics, is how the school has really connected us. And football kind of all brought us all together, and outside of school, you know, the reason we are hanging out is because of football. So as a football team and as a community, I feel like football has a big impact.
Just Coach Hancock, that's what I give a shout out to. Coach Hancock, he's real cool, he's funny, we get along really great. And you know, he's been believing in me for a long time, always pushed me to get better, become a better person on and off the field.
Timothy Harmon, Dylan Carnes, Mark Wagner, the three seniors who I was probably closest with besides Chris Monroe, but and Anthony Flores, but those four, just watching their energy before the game, before we even were on the field, was just amazing. It was so easy to feed off of, and honestly gave me goosebumps whenever Mark was giving his pregame speeches, and whenever he would come off the field hot after making a play, it was just it's something I've never experienced before.
I definitely want to say thanks to Coach Walsh in particular, because I think you remember, Bradley, like whenever we became a purple school in middle school,
yeah,
they brought all the some of the coaches over for just to watch us work out and stuff like that. I think Coach Walsh was there almost every day, or from what I can remember.
A lot, yeah. And every other coach, you know, like Coach Frazier and Coach Locke and Minch, all the other coaches, you know, like that helped me with weightlifting or in the weight room, like, that have shaped me to be who I've become, and with football and everything, like it's crazy to think where we came from our eighth grade year to now, with the help of all these wonderful coaches, and it's just amazing.
Absolutely. One player that really like stood out to me was my locker buddy, I guess, and also the other guard, Bradley Dorsett. He's not here right now, but me and him, I think, had just a constant competition at who would be the better guard, and I think that pushed us both to achieve, like make ourselves better at our position and everything, and I think that helped us push ourselves to really achieve new heights. And he's a great friend, and his energy is just amazing to be around, because he just makes you see like the better side of things constantly.
Shout out to Coach Breyer. He always keeps practice fun,
energetic, pushed me to be a better person inside school, outside of school, everywhere.
Coach Mitch and Coach Walsh for pushing me every day, and after we're all done, getting me just two more sets and just to make me better. And just want to thank them for everything.
The struggle that we've personally been through definitely helps bring together the team. I mean, the struggle always brings people together. And I think, if anything, it just made our brotherhood as a whole that much stronger.
Our teammates just seeing us like go through what we had to go through, and us still being hungry, I don't know, sometimes hungrier than them.
Yeah.
That made them 10 times more hungry when they played whole practice.
A small victory like that, and seeing the smile on their faces when I tell them that, them being happy for me, that was a really, really cool feeling. Even if it is just something small like that.
It definitely made us, it wasn't all bad, but it definitely made us much better leaders. Because we couldn't do it with our actions, leading by example. We have to do it with our words.
I think both of us are definitely big leader by example guys, and Having to use our voices is something that was new to us, and something that we had learned and definitely got better at as the season went on. Walking out over the stands, there's nothing else like that. That's a truly once in a lifetime experience. I'm gonna miss that a lot.
Go to play football again, and I didn't know I felt like they were my actual. Coach Locke is the eye in the sky.
I think it's really cool getting to work with Coach day in, day out. I really didn't realize until the season's over, I was like, quarterbacks are the only people that get to do that. We're the only people that are really with Coach Huff, like 24/7 during practice. Yeah. I definitely want to say thank you to our trainers and the whole training staff. I mean, they spend just as much time out here as we do. Even though you're gone, still mean the world. walking out over the stands of this, there's nothing else like that. That's a truly once in a lifetime experience. I'm gonna miss that a lot.
I think one of the funniest stories by far that I can remember was freshman year, and it was with the linemen. We were kind of on the grass field, and Coach Minch took all of my position over, and he was working with us, and he told us to take our helmets off, and we were all just kind of watching him teach us some new ways to kick step and whatnot. And then he noticed that Tawny wasn't doing something right, so he was like, "Here, Tawny, come here." So he grabbed Tawny by his shoulder pads and put him in his shirt. But Coach Minch had a huge, huge barbecue sauce stain right where Tawny's face was, and he just started smearing his face around in the barbecue sauce stain, and then he like let him go, and it was like. I remember he told Tawny, he was like, "Hey, there's a little barbecue sauce for you," or something like that. We were all just dying laughing. I think we just laughed for like a good 5 minutes on that one. That was a period.
Hey, you know I got dropped the girl on.
Oh, dude.
At the banquet.
All right,
we won't do that.
All right. I get all the coaches
listen. Receiver. Kelly, you win 400.
No winner.
Lanier, Hancock,
get all of them.
Coach Jones. Coach Jones, you ain't safe.
But come here, dude.
Come here, dang, dude. Yeah, said, Caleb, you stupid.
I wouldn't even do anything.
That's probably what you
want to
do.
Oh, no, because one time he's like, "Caleb, you stupid." I was like, "No, I'm dyslexic, though."
fat Nier was always
oh, yeah, Lanier.
You always get on Lanier, and he'd come right back at you, too. Every single time. He always talked about everybody's mama.
I don't know why.
What about Coach Jimbo? I always like imagine him like sitting on like phone books when he drives.
He reminded me, we had the best looking, he reminded me of the dude from the Incredibles with the suit on.
all I want to know is how big is Lanier's budget for his Superman undershirts.
Wow.
Always.
I found them at
Duke. Is he stretching?
His shirt's got stretch marks.
The S don't even be an S in words.
Who else? Y'all ain't safe. Y'all ain't safe.
I think the funniest moments in football is when this man right here would throw up every pregame just to get those nerves out.
I enjoy that a lot.
Yeah,
I don't know why they like it so much.
Every time I'd look around and I'd be like, "Where's Mark?" Throwing up.
Yeah, Mark's not throwing up. And he's not excited. How are you going to be excited?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah, I'd say my most embarrassing moment in football came early freshman year. Me and Anthony are like kind of competing to see, you know, who's like the best linebacker or whatever, because this man is already, you know, with the big boys. So we're down there, little freshmen, doing some drills, and someone whispers in Anthony's ear something, and all I know is I'm being like a dummy pretty much, because Anthony comes and just puts me on my rear hind.
Bosom.
My bosom. And, you know, everyone gets a football, everyone's like, oh, Anthony just hit Dylan. And, you know, you're just sitting there like, I'm about to get on my mother.